So the first thing I do is I put my hair away. Of course, we want our hair out of our faces when we're working. And now I'm ready to tell your future. So the first step is priming my skin before I put any of the foundation on. And the primer I'm using today is something, it's an oldie but a goodie. I've been using this for probably 5-6 years now. It's by Guerlain. So I just use one pump of this. It's a clear sort of gel type consistency. And then I like using my fingers. I think it's more, I don't know, organic when I touch my skin. There, and it just takes a moment to dry. We're ready for the foundation. This is my La Mer, and the first thing I do is I warm it up on my hand. By the way, I am using shell number 11. That is my skin tone's color. And then once it's kind of warmed up and spread out on my skin, I start to apply it with my fingers. And then I take a damp sponge. So I'm not an expert. I'm not a makeup artist. I am just a singer on a budget doing her own makeup for today's show. Okay, so now that I'm more or less blended out with the base, we want to start concealing. This is the Tarte Shape Tape. And for under my eyes, I like to mix two different colors. I use the light medium sand, and that's the general color of my skin. But if I wanna, you know, have a little brightening effect, I try to mix it with light sand. Now I have less eye bags. Of course, I can't remove them completely. I cannot cancel my eye bags because they are part of who I am. So the next step is setting my under eye area with some setting powder. This is what I'm using. Pick it up with the sponge, same sponge I used for my foundation, and just kind of softly bake under the eyes. The next step is my favorite step. This is the eyebrows. And I know this is controversial because there are so many ways of doing eyebrows. So I'm just gonna talk about how I do them. I don't know if you guys will agree or disagree with me, but it's always fun to play. It's just makeup. If you don't like it, you can wash it off. And I brush my eyebrow hairs, which can get kind of unruly. Like, I haven't trimmed them. I usually trim my eyebrow hairs, but there we go. So I am brushed up. And then this is the K Palette Lasting Eyebrow Tint Pen. I usually start with the middle area of the brow because it'll help me sort of calculate how prominent I want the arch. And if I feel like I've overdrawn a bit, like I've been a bit too heavy, I just go back with a spoolie and brush it so that it kind of blends in together. So once I have both eyebrows drawn in, I go on to the next eyebrow step. Yes, this is a process. I'm not a one-step kind of eyebrow girl. To kind of lock them in and give them more staying power for the rest of the show. And what I use to do this is an eyebrow mascara. The first one I use is, it's faded already because I use it so much. The first one I use is from a brand called Kate. Then I take this eyebrow comb separator. So if I still have a few hairs that are out of place, here comes my eyebrow secret. I take one of these ratty old brushes. I'm embarrassed that I have this, but I love it so much I will not throw it away. And I just lightly comb the hairs that I want to stick down. The third step, I'm going to revisit this wonderful product, the Tarte Shape Tape in Light Medium Sand. And I'm going to select the skinniest flat brush I have. This is by MAC. I'm proud to say that this is an 11-year-old brush and it is still alive. This was a Christmas gift 11 years ago. And I would say my finishing step is the other eyebrow mascara or eyebrow gel that I showed you a while ago. This is a newer product. It's called Life Brow by Sunny's Face. So there, that is the meticulous eyebrow process. Up next, we have the eyes. I used this like super old, beaten up, it's been all over the world with me palette from, see, it's so kawawa na, I need a new palette. This is from Kat Von D. You can't even see the shade names anymore, they've blurred out. But if you have the same palette, it's the one at the very end. And then, I'm gonna use this Lorac Pro palette. And this has also been all over the world with me. As you can tell, Lorac is now wasak. This is from a recent plane ride. I don't know what happened, but yeah, when I got home, the mirror broke. But yeah, I don't believe in bad luck. I believe that you create your own luck, so this doesn't bother me. And the color I'm taking is Brulee. So I'm just lightly going in. So I'm gonna dip into Rosebud. I'm gonna go from the outer edge of my eyes. Now I'm gonna go for a third color. This is a darker shade, so I wanna like tap it off a bit on the brush. Now I'm gonna use a smaller brush. And this one is by Morphe. It is an older brush from about 4 or 5 years ago. Still alive, so I still use it. I'm gonna dip into the same shade, still Merlot. Okay, so now I kind of want to make the outer side and the inner side more uniform. So I'm gonna bring in a fourth shade and I'm using warm ginger for this. Okay, so now I'm gonna do the lids. And for this, I'm just gonna use my hands. I'm gonna dip into the shade Iced Rose. So now I'm gonna go to the under part of the eye and I'm using a Zoeva brush again. This one is called the 230 and I'm gonna dip into the shade Cognac first and I'm gonna push it towards the outer corner. Now I'm gonna go back to the Zoeva pencil brush and dip into the shade Merlot, which I already used a while ago. So now most of the color is on my eyes, but I'm definitely not done yet. I just want to clean up under the eyes so I have a clearer look of what's going on, what the situation is, what I need to fix, what I need to go back over. So I'm going to take this brush from Catchy and just dust the bake off. Now the next thing I want to do is curl my lashes. This eyelash curler has been with me everywhere also. I always pack it. It is in my everyday bag. It's been abused and used to its fullest, but it still works. I'm just gonna curl my lashes. So the next thing I'm gonna do is attempt, keyword attempt, to draw a wingtip. Okay, so they're not going to be 100% perfect, but I will try to get them as close to each other as I can in terms of the flick. Okay, so I'm going to leave that for now and add some mascara. Another oldie but a goodie. This one is the Roller Lash. I try to amp that up with mascara. So I don't have bottom lashes. I wish I could use this product on my bottom lashes, but I have like 3. So if I put mascara on my bottom lashes, you're probably gonna notice how few I have even more. So I just leave it that way. And that's why I like to smoke the under eye area. Or if I want the illusion, but I don't want to deal with having mascara with no lashes on the bottom, what I'll do is I'll take my brown liner from a while ago and just take the very finest tip, like make sure it's clean. This is for stage, okay? So I won't do this on a regular day, but I will just draw the tiniest marks so it doesn't look like I have 0 lashes under my eyes. Next, I'm gonna do my bronzer, contouring. For stage, it can be very important. Actually, I'd say it's vital because a lot of the stage lights are coming at you from a high up position, and when you don't have the right contouring, your face can fall flat. And I do this with this is the Charlotte Tilbury palette. It's called Filmstar Bronze and Glow. I've been using this for about 5-6 years. It was first introduced to me by my makeup artist friend, shout out Carla Avancena. Please tell me if I'm doing something wrong. Just take a very light brush. By the way, this brush I've been using cost me a few hundred pesos lang, and I've had it, guess what, I've had this for 15 years. I've had this for a long time. It is still intact. The glue still works. This is from an Aussie brand called Bloom. They don't sell it here in the Philippines anymore, but I swear by this brush. I will die without this brush. It was not expensive, but it lasts really long. This is the bronzer shade. And I'm just gonna go by where my cheekbone is. I don't have the highest cheekbones. I wish they were higher, but this is what I was born with. And now I'm gonna take this super old brush. All my brushes are really old. Kawawa ba ako? All my brushes are really old, but I love them. So until they fall apart, I will use them. I'm gonna take this angled brush, which is actually an eyeshadow brush, but I use it for contouring my nose. So I just dip lightly to the same contouring shade, and then just start here, the inner part of my brow. And I have more of a nose now. The next thing I'm gonna do is go back to my cheek area with some blush and a little bit of bronzer of a different shade. And I'm gonna take my very old 15-year-old cheek brush and dip into this shade right here. Now I'm gonna go onto the blush part of my face, and I'm still using the same palette. This is by Hourglass. So I'm gonna dip into these two shades. I'm gonna mix them. And then on days when I'm feeling a little bit extra, I will use a second blush. And this one is by Guerlain. And just go over the apples in a higher area. There we go. And then this ambient powder, the two shades on the left, I like using this lightest shade. I love for under the eyes. That is it for my face makeup, but now I'm gonna go on to the lips. So before you do anything to your lips, the first thing I highly recommend is moisturizing them. I would highly recommend a lip liner because you want your lips to be in place. So I'm using this lip liner from MAC, and it's called Half Red. Once I have my basic line on, I fill in the lips a little more so it doesn't look crazy. So for today, I am gonna use one of my favorite matte lipstick formulas. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Matte Revolution in Bond Girl. I love the name. That is my dream. I wish I could be a Bond girl. And then sometimes what I do is I take a second shade of lipstick, which is lighter. Slightly lighter. So now we go to the lashes, and I am using these lashes. They are mink lashes from Catchy's Beauty Supplies. And then I'm just gonna paint the band. When the white glue turns a little bit clear and a little bit bluish in tinge, that's when I know it's time to stick them on. So just for me, I try to raise my eyebrows as high as I can so I get full view of my lid. So my lash glue is dry, my lashes are fixed. Sometimes it takes a few times to get them right, so I'm just gonna squeeze them one more time with my lash curler to kind of blend in my natural lashes if they can fit. And then one last coat of mascara. I'm just gonna dip into the eyeshadow one last time. Pretty much done. What we have left to do is set the face. And I am using MAC Fix Plus in the rose water. Ooh, smells nice. All right, that is my makeup look. I'm just gonna let my hair down. And I like to use dry shampoo to do that. I'm not very particular with the brand, but today I'm just using Dove dry shampoo. There we go. My hair is alive. And that's my beauty look for today. Alright everyone, that was my show makeup DIY look. If you like what you're watching, then please click subscribe and hit the notification bell. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you at the next episode of Nicole Laurel Asensio No Limits.